This second chance means everything in the world to me. I jumped off a pole in the Outback for peanut butter and gave away $1 million when I did it. Having to replay that history over and over for 14 years really does a number on you.
Jeff, the tribe has spoken.
This is my opportunity to rewrite my own story. I'm more mature, I'm a lot smarter, and I'm not jumping off anything for peanut butter.
Jeff Varner.
Yeah.
You could argue that people might have forgotten about you. It was 14 years ago.
A long time ago.
How often have you thought about doing this again?
A lot. A whole lot.
I can even feel or hear the butterflies coming through your voice.
A little bit, yeah. There's excitement, there are butterflies, there's emotion. You know, there's a lot going on. Name this one Kimmy, but we can't kill her. Shireen's talking a mile a minute. This train took off, and I'm glad I'm on it. I just got on it. I don't care who's pulling me in the woods. Yes is your answer.
But us?
It's like, damn, mama, slow down. I just got here. And, you know, a train will only go as fast as its conductor will take it, and she's hit the gas. What just bit my ass? When I did it the first time in the Outback, it was all about the adventure. It wasn't about the strategy at all. I haven't played Survivor in 15 years. Is this the way you do it now? I'll be 50 next year. That's a big year. And most men my age go through a midlife crisis. They buy a Corvette. They cheat on their wives. I go on Survivor. It's not about a midlife crisis. It's about a midlife quest. And the second half of my life begins with Survivor Second Chance. I'm the OG here, and I feel like the baby. Day two, I feel like I've never played this game before. It's odd. This game is way too fast. I can't keep up with it. But I'm playing hard. And I'm trying not to look like I'm playing hard, but I'm playing hard. There are two divisions happening on this beach right now. There's the people who build the shelter, the old schoolers. Old school wants to do it the way old school did it. You work and that's what your value is. And the new school wants to just take off running down the beach and get me into an alliance. But I don't want to turn on the shelter people, my old folks. I don't want to do that. It's my second chance and I'm in something I've never been in before and I don't know what to do. Old school, new school, what do I do? Jeff, I think people know what's happening here tonight. I don't care what they say. There's been a lot of work on this beach in the last 3 days. Huge. I've been doing nothing but picking up on cues for 3 days, so much so that I've had very little sleep. I've had very little time to do things that I would have done in Australia. It's a whole different world, and I don't know if my old school counterparts are participating in this new world as hard as I am. I'm balls to the wall, and I'm dying to see what's going to happen tonight. I think if there is an elephant in the room, we're about to find out.
Wow.
It's my second chance. I don't want to screw it up. This is an important night.
First person voted out of Survivor Second Chance, Vetus. Did you bring me your torch?
Spencer and Shireen are quite comfortable, but I'm not so sure they should be as comfortable as they are. I'm serious. My whole plan with voting out Vetus was to teach the old schoolers to play this game finally, and to set the pace to get rid of Shireen and Spencer. They're playing way too hard, strategy-wise. I want to get one of them out of the mix. This game is moving like lightning, Terry. And all of these threats, I've got to go. That vote last night was a wake-up call. Get off your ass and play this game. This is not 2001. I want to vote out Spencer. Or Shireen. I'm looking for a spy shack.
Yeah.
Abby's our own little Brazilian soap opera that we can just turn on and watch whenever we want to. And there are buttons you push to get it at various levels of entertainment. See Abby as somebody everybody hates, which makes her somebody that I know I can beat. She is the perfect tool to help me win $1 million. Oh my God, this is delicious. Who needs food when you've got Abby?
You and Terry have a good time.
Yes.
You're a nice man.
Yes.
Keep thinking about lining with him.
Me too.
I don't want you to go anywhere. I think you're fabulous.
Thank you.
I like your little moments. They turn me on. What we do is we vote as a unit and we get Spencer and Shireen. I'll get Terry to do it, Kelly to do it, Lou to do it, me and you. That's fine.
Okay.
It's numbers.
That challenge was a nightmare and we ended up losing. But it didn't dawn on me until just now that Spencer and Shireen had their fate in their own hands and they lost it. Now, one of those two is going home tonight. How poetic. My whole thing is get rid of the threats as soon as you can.
Spencer is a huge strategic threat. That kid is the smartest young man I've ever met in my entire life. Shireen is all of that. Plus, she's emotional. She knows how to talk to you like your best friend. She's a salesperson. They are two heads on one snake, so it doesn't matter which one we chop off. Oh, Abby's devastated that Shireen didn't stand up for her last night.
I know.
Barry Dietz sat up with her all night long like her father. Oh. So she woke up completely loyal to him.
So who's good right now? You, PG, Wiggs, Dietz,
everybody,
Wu.
But yeah. Shireen.
Okay.
And Spencer.
Yeah.
It's over.
Jeff, are Shireen and Spencer right to be concerned? Have you guys narrowed it down to one of those two going?
Yes.
Second person voted out of Survivor Second Chance. Shireen. Varner, did getting rid of Shireen put this tribe in a space where it now feels like, okay, we can work with this group?
Hell yes.
Angkor. The new Angkor tribe has four people from the old Takeo tribe. Wu, Varner, PG, and Abby, and they are joined by Tasha and Savage.
Savage and Tasha want me to come and join them. They will get me to the jury. Isn't that a lovely invitation? I want to say, hey, you're on the bottom. Those two we can get rid of like that. I don't know if they're making deals, but they're running up and down the beach, talking to everybody. I need to make sure they are not taking away Abby Maria and they're not taking away PG, because there's a lot that could go wrong.
Oh, God.
Sending Angkor to tribal council, where somebody will be the third person voted out a second chance.
Hey, we got a rat.
Worth. Varner, what was happening?
I looked at Wiggles, and Tasha jumps back and says, right. We got a rat.
Jeff, we're trying to bond as a tribe. I mean, that doesn't send a good message. Now, like, we're already down,
listen,
morale is down.
I made a deal with you, and then he's turned right around and made a deal with her. Jeff, you're wrong.
Are we still an alliance?
Yes, yes. Came back to this camp thinking I was done. But if I can take this cloud that's over me right now and sling it over somebody else, I'm gonna do it.
To today's challenge, where a meltdown occurred.
Hi. I was sending a signal to someone on the other tribe I care about, and Tasha just jumps out of nowhere and calls me a rat, and I wasn't being a rat. I didn't feel like I was being a rat, and that just hit me. I've had no sleep, I've had no food, I'm emotional, and honestly, I don't remember it. It was an emotional meltdown that I don't recall. People can recover from all kinds of things. How great would it be if I could escape here tonight without one vote? Wouldn't that be crazy? I've heard so many names thrown around this afternoon, I have no idea what's happening.
Whose name have you heard thrown around?
I've heard Abby's name thrown around, I've heard PG's name thrown around, I've heard my name thrown around. So I guess Savage and Tasha have found their way from the bottom of the heap to the top.
So Jeff, now you've heard all the feedback. What's happening tonight?
I said it earlier, I have no idea. But I believe what I said. Savage and Tasha are in control of tonight's vote.
Third person voted out of Survivor Second Chance. PG, need to bring your torch?
I can't believe I'm here. I dodged a bullet. I came back from that challenge thinking I was gone. But I did not get one single vote. I am indebted to these people now, which makes me sick. I've got to kiss their asses. But this is my second chance, so I'm gonna do what I have to do.
All right, we have our callers. It is Jeff for Angkor. Angkor, out there, 16, take off your mask. Let's go, you got a dig. Ow! Varner drops a piece on himself, sending Angkor back to tribal council for the second straight time.
Varner, you okay?
It's my pinky toe. It's gonna hurt like a bitch for a few days.
Hey.
Clearly, it's either me or Wu tonight. Abby is so in their laps right now, she's completely turned her back on both of us. But the one thing that I have working for me is I've never voted for Abby. I have saved Abby twice. So if Abby's the one making all the calls here, I might just squeak by another one.
I mean, I love you. You know that. We've worked well together. I kind of miss you. Like, we don't talk and cut up like we did before. I miss my Abby time.
One of those big pieces slammed right down on my foot. And it's purple, it's painful, and today was a nightmare. I've never felt like this. I mean, to not be able to put two thoughts together, to get up and walk to use the bathroom, what was that? Oh my God. To deal with moments like that, it's just, it drains you. But I just keep thinking of the millions of people who voted me here, and I keep going.
For my alliance.
But you haven't been in this alliance. You voted against it. He voted for Abby.
Twice.
Tasha, you've been kind of closed off to me because I think you see me as this crafty person, but I trust you, and I am loyal to you. Savage?
Yes.
Absolutely loyal to you. We have a lot more in common. We're both old school.
Yes.
And Abby Z, I have been loyal to you since day one because I adore you. I will not vote for you. I have not voted for you. I am loyal to you till the end of it. So I hope you repay that to me. Ugh. You rock.
Fourth person voted out of Survivor Second Chance. Jeff, that's three. That's enough. Need to bring me your torch.
A little bit.
Barner?
Yep.
The tribe has spoken. Time for you to go.
Thank you, Jeff. I have a passion that's been cooking for 15 years, and all of a sudden this opportunity pops up, and it came flying out in all directions. But in terms of the life adventure, in terms of the charge to move forward with the second half of my life, I absolutely got what I needed, and I'm very grateful.